aside from the fact that I'm still alive. None of this surprises me.
Hey guys, Flamery Hacker here, and in this video I'm gonna talk about Call of Duty Black Ops 2 and what to expect. Alright, so you guys seen the new preview of the Call of Duty Black Ops 2 on the Call of Duty channel on YouTube. So it looks pretty good, I like it. And as you know, the original Black Ops took place during the Cold War. I call it the first Cold War because the new Cold War hasn't happened yet. The Call of Duty Black Ops 2 is the direct sequel, which will take place in part during the fictional Second Cold War in the year 2025. You will play as David Mason, the son of Alex Mason, the previous game protagonist. Alex will return as a playable character in flashbacks to the late 1980s as the faction enforcer of the Reagan Doctrine. He will be in charge of the army proxy wars with Russia in locations like Nicaragua and Afghanistan. Black Ops 2's story spans generations, claiming to tell us the father and son have a mutual enemy, Raul Menendez. Menendez is a mysterious figure we know he's somehow tied to the Reagan era conflict in Nicaragua. As Lamia, Menendez might harbor ill towards the United States, considering the government was harsh. To provide additional funds to the countries rebuilt at the period, Flamia won't provide a definitive answer just yet. Alright, so the story, well, Man of Steel returned to help and develop the time-bending tale and create what both parties believe will be an unforgettable villain. So this new antagonist is like the main one, the small three macro. But Masons will receive help from Frank Woods. As you remember, or as I remember, Frank Woods was killed during the first Black Ops, but I don't know, that's something we should talk about later on. Alright, so Frank Woods, who somehow did not die in the ring of Black Ops in that game campaign, who was wearing a belt of live grenades out of a window, hit an intel on Black Ops, hint at the possibility of Woods being alive at a POV camp in Hanoi. A very old Woods is still alive in 2025, and he is the narrator of Black Ops 2. He explains what happened in the 80s while on assignment with Alex Mason and why it matters in the game present. Woods has an ongoing story on his own, and though it's nuclear, the team has amazing goals for this new Call of Duty. Maybe I'm way off, but Black Ops, Woods have been brainwashed in Hanoi like Alex Mason was in Vokuda in the arena of Black Ops. Anyhow, in the late 1980s, which will be roughly a third of the game, you will see how Menendez becomes a monster of a man, and in 2025 you will see what he's capable of doing. What's most important, though, Lamia tells me it's very amazing. We gotta be grounded. He repeats times and again like a holy man. Alright, so Lamia tells the future war won't be about oil but rare earth elements. Rare earth elements? What are you talking about? Alright, so the minerals are essential to many of today's most important products, such for example smartphones, such as your iPhone or Androids. They all use energy, they're energy devices. So basically everything that uses energy is electronic. So going back to Black Ops, Lamia plays a clip of Obama talking about the necessity of China's participation with the Western market in trading earth elements fairly. He shows an interview with a Japanese businessman discussing the danger of China's complete control of all these elements. So he gets a scary thing. The team volleys between clips from news and military television programs, talking about war and things about the future. They paint a war in which a hacker would bring a superpower to its knees. Alright, so advanced robotics, security system, airplanes, all military technology, our best weapons may one day be used against us. Oliver North, who is a consult on the game, says he's not worried about the guy who hijacks that one plane, but about the guy who hijacks all of them. Which it is the gameplay. It's cool. So on June 19, 2024, Los Angeles, California, a well-dressed man covered in blood shrieks in agony. David Mason pushes him into a seat and looks around the limousine, spying the president. She looks like a young Hillary Clinton. We hear G20 leaders across the world are under attack. A vehicle is spraying down the highway. Outside of blinking construction signs, call for an evacuation of Los Angeles. Above a swarm of dust, maybe 100 of drones and wolverine, the skyscrapers and roads. So talking about here is just that in the future, not to, from to right now is 2012, so let's say 5-10 years, every single airplane or car will be, you don't need a human anymore, basically. In other words, you don't need a human to control those airplanes, or everything is done by computer. I mean, you can do many things on your laptop right now. You can be home developing a new app and become, you know, a billionaire through that app, or you can be at Los Angeles if you're working in the military and just controlling an airplane and go attack Afghanistan. You can also shop online, buy clothes or anything that you need. So Mason pulls the president from the car, dashes across the highway and hops into a turret atop a military vehicle, and they just go and run away. The weapon blocks on a half a dozen of drones at a time, chasing them with a bunch of rockets. So one of these drones shot out the air, crashed out into the highway and skips like a twist stone over Mason, nearly slicking the head from his shoulder. So the president, you know, is by free by a couple of soldiers while Mason provides cover with sniper rifle. Alright, so basically when Mason pulls the trigger, it kicks sharply back, laying out a pretty small, like wood slapping a bunch of shotguns. Mason finally makes his way down to the low road, hops in a sport utility vehicle and drives through the abandoned street, hammering cars and killing enemy soldiers. Up ahead, the freeway begins to collapse. So this game, you know, from what I'm reading right now, it is cool. So a female pilot keeps watch over Mason's from a vertical takeoff or landing aircraft, a Harrier-like jet. Remember the from St. Rose 3rd? She provides direction through the deadly battlefield. Most of the city's full bomb is a war zone, shouts some guy. The Pentagon and Wall Street are equal. Our warship we hear before the red semi side with this vehicle. Alright, so the goal of this game is to kill the AI control team and complete a series of objectives in any order. When a person dies or a body is destroyed, it is gone and you inhabit or whatever remains. Run out of people or town and the mission is lost. This is Strike Force mission on a shipping dock. The mission is to capture the A, B and C points. The employees from Terrorjudge running the demo makes quick work the opposition. One moment he's a soldier, the next he's a CLAW, he's running a drone. Now he's a mobile rocket launcher called Atomos Ground Robot or AGR. He pulls out the commander's view and sees what squad controlled by the computer on his behalf, maintaining status, taking cover and making careful movements against the enemy. He sits back into a soldier and calls the airstrike to take out the goal, completing the mission. Amy laughs. You could play the mission this way or you could just play a single soldier. It's totally up to the player, they say. In a way, well, it looks like a single player multiplayer, one person controlling the entire team in a game of domination. Multiplayer is sport and zombie mode, but I love zombie mode. Multiplayer is set in 2025, possibly game design director David Von Hatter explains the decision was purely gameplay motivated. He is incredibly careful not to reveal much of anything. Speaking vertical thoughts. They're planning to kill some spacecraft, he tells the he won't say which in the book. One thing promises is 60 frames per second. 60 frames a second, whether it's you see it or not, you felt it, there's no hitching. It is same you feel when your brain feels the controller in back. That's why 60 frames is important to us. So as you can see, many things that you saw or you heard or watched or whatever you went online and Google, many things are just made up stories or things are true. You just try to keep it secret because, you know, it's their business. So, but basically, it is a cool game based on the campaign and multiplayer. I heard it's going to be new demolition where some airplanes will be, you will be the airplane destroying other airplanes. There's a lot in Black Ops that you need to find out. So right now that's all information I have. I don't have much. So I heard it is gonna be Black Ops Zombies mode, and it's not a for sure thing, but it is. Well, for what I know, they'll be bringing back the popular zombie cop mode from COD Black Ops in the first Black Ops. In a new interview, zombie mode has been another game entirely. The campaign pretty big and ambitious, the multiplayer is good too, and they really are creating another game with the zombie. It is the most powerful game on Call of Duty. The development team for Black Ops 2 matches their ambition. There's a few hundred people working on the game, however, most of the team is located at their job. This is in direct contrast with Modern Warfare 2, which was developed by 3 studios. There's over 250 people at Call of Duty, but there is over 300 people working on the project. We do not contract on test teams that added part of the company. Those others are actually employees of Terra. But there's over 300 people working in the game right now. In the summary code from previous Call of Duty games, players fend off waves of their own death. Each kill gives players money, which they can spend on new weapons or bolstering their defenses. So hormone modes offers in other games, there's gonna be a new style. For example, one zombie map let players take on the role of John F. Kennedy and Fidel Castro among other history figures. The future setting Black Ops should allow Terrier to make the updated zombies mode even amazing. Remember the moon base map from Black Ops zombie mode? Imagine something even weirder than that. So that's basically it. That's all I have for Black Ops right now, and I'm sorry for the bad video quality and audio quality. My computer is crashing a lot. So I'll post another video talking about Call of Duty Black Ops 2 Zombies and another review for the new Call of Duty Black Ops 2. I'll provide more information about multiplayer. So that's it. Thanks for watching and remember to subscribe. That will really help me out. Hello. Thank you.